Hello and welcome to Breezy Chatter. Today I'm going to be talking about Ready to Love, DC edition, and it's episode 6. So it looks like this time it is men's choice and the men are at the gentleman's lounge and they're with nephew Tommy. And we are now at the halfway mark. And nephew Tommy is encouraging the men to give women that they are not really considering or that are not, I guess, their number one choices, a second shot. So we start with Zadia and Walter. That date seemed to go pretty well. Family and traditions very important to them. And Zadia was quite impressed with Walter. So, I mean, the conversation was fine. There was nothing, no drama. Will they pick up where this date left off or will they continue to pursue their initial interests? Then we have Sean and Sabrina. Sean is the new guy. He wants kids. Sabrina has one child and she's not interested in any more children. She has a lot on her plate. She really respected Sean's genuineness. It will be interesting to see how this works out because although they like each other, they have different wants. And kids are a deal breaker in a lot of relationships. If I want kids and you don't, like, why are we together? It doesn't make sense. And it really is a time waster. And Sean did say that he's not about wasting time anymore. And Sabrina did say that she wants to be extremely careful with whomever the next man is going to be that she lets into her life because she has a 9-year-old daughter. And she doesn't want her daughter to see her dating multiple men. You know, that's never a good look. And I like that she's protective in that way, and she's not going to have her daughter exposed to all these different types of men. This is Uncle Charlie. This is Uncle Dave. I'm glad that she's not going to do that because it just creates a lot of confusion. So we're moving on to Phil and Aisha. It seems as though they have been talking on the phone, but have not really gone out on any dates. And they had a meaningful date. She really trusts him. She feels like when she's talking to him and in his company, she's in a safe place. He sort of asked some real questions. He said, it's time to get down to the nitty gritty. He said, and I want to know, I've heard you give different answers or conflicting answers where kids are concerned. Are you interested in having more kids or are you not? And that's when she sort of broke down and she told him that she had one miscarriage and she's had complicated pregnancies. She has 2 children, and I guess she almost lost both of those children. So that was a very emotional bring up. And she was able to share that with him because she feels that comfortable with him. So Phil and Aisha, they made a really strong connection. And that was, like I said, a meaningful date. We'll see how far or if things progress between the two of them. Then we have Camille and Naeem. Something about Camille is just very immature. And Naeem is her polar opposite. Naeem did ask her out on the date, but I just wonder if he felt like this was an act of futility because he knows who she's really interested in. He's well aware that Camille is only checking for Cornelius. Was this a waste of time? It appears to be a waste of time. They're both into fitness. Camille did ask Naeem about kids. And he said, well, let's focus on the relationship first. Let's not put the cart before the horse. Let's get to know each other first before we start talking about kids. And then she goes even further after he's telling her, relationship first, kids after. She's saying, well, how many kids do you want? And he said, well, let's start with one. And when he said that, it was so refreshing to hear because this is a man who's living in reality. He's not saying, oh, I want 5 kids, 3 boys, 2 girls. I want to have my boy first. I just really respected that he seems really grounded. And let's have a relationship. We'll have a child should that arise, should that happen. You know, hopefully we'll be married before then. And let's just take it as it comes, one day at a time, living in reality. So I really enjoyed that. That was really refreshing. And then Camille wants to know about his finances, wants to know how much money he makes. asking the man if he's at least making six figures. He did not give her any answers, okay? He said, I'm not answering that. And to him, that was a red flag. And I find it interesting that Camille wants to know about the finances of all these men. Is she trying to find out who's going to pay off her student loans? You are heavily in debt, and you're asking these men about what's in their wallets? Ugh, turn off. So that date was a waste of time, like I said. Then we had another double date. We had Sabrina and Dante and Frank and Mumin. Sabrina and Dante seem to hit it off. They each have children of their own. Sabrina has a daughter. Dante has two girls, one boy. Three different babies' moms. He said it's drama-free because, you know, when you hear that a guy has multiple children with different women, you automatically think this is going to be a high drama situation and you sort of gravitate away from that. But he reassured Sabrina that there is no drama. But, you know, that's easy for him to say now. You just never know what could happen should Sabrina decide that she wants to take on Dante and his three children. What would happen with these children's moms? Well, I feel like the possibility of a relationship between the two of them is ideal since they sort of have a ready-made family. Sabrina is not looking to have any more children, so that might work in their favor or may work in her favor. And then we have Sean and Tasia. They're both Baptists. He wants children. She's ready for kids. She told him her biological clock is ticking and her mom is tapping on the shoulder saying, where are my grandchildren? That was a very surface date. We don't know how much more they have in common with each other. It was a good start for the two of them. And then we have Cornelius and Courtney. This is the first time that we've actually saw the two of them on a date together without anyone else in the picture. It was refreshing. I said, oh, finally, we get to see the two of them together without Camille lurking, without Camille in the picture. Courtney did not hold back her feelings. She let him know that she's very much interested in him. She's physically attracted to him, which is problematic for Cornelius. He said he's Christian through and through. So the more he spoke to her and the more they interacted with each other, touching and feeling, he realized that she's not gonna be the right woman for him. So then they met with a gentleman and we have the bottom two women, Camille and Courtney. Dante met with Camille and Courtney met with Walter. And Camille, I think she was sort of nervous because she knew what this date was about. But Dante sort of put her mind at ease when he let her know that they decided that she is still in the running for Ready to Love. And Camille said something, which was funny. She's going to say, don't send me home because I'm not feeling you. I mean, Camille, you're only interested in one guy. And if those guys really didn't care about Cornelius and the fact that he's interested in you, you would be sent home. You've made no connections. You've only made one connection. That's it. So, well, as far as our eyes can see on the screen, because we know there are a lot of things happening behind the scenes, but we can't speak to those things because we don't know. We don't really know what's going on behind the scenes. We only know what's presented to us. So Camille is saved and Walter sends Courtney home. I don't see any major connections with anyone except maybe Camille and Cornelius. Everyone else is sort of not sure. It's kind of different from the way it was last season where you sort of knew there were a few couples that were together. You knew that they were going to make it through to the end. Whereas in this season, everything is still very much up in the air and we're at the halfway mark. So we'll have to wait and see what happens next week. Thank you for your time. If you liked my commentary, hit like, subscribe, leave comments. Thank you for your time. Until next time. Ta-ta.